One of the most frequent questions I get about the query function is there a way to use the column headings when I'm referencing them? Instead of having to use this A, B, C, D, what if I want to say, can I use category or quantity sold or unit price, one of the actual column labels, one of the headings in my dataset? So let's see a really basic query function now. And I will highlight my data. And we'll just select two columns, select C and H. We just want to see the item and the total sales for that item. And not particularly useful, you might want to do some aggregations and whatnot, but for now, we'll keep it really simple because all we're interested in is the columns, pulling out the column names. So right now it's C and H. Make this a little bigger. C and H. And of course, the reason we're so interested in this question is because, you know, if a colleague comes along and says, I need to add a new column in here, and this is my new column, then look at this. Our query over here, which is our aggregated data, this is our important analysis we're doing. This now, column H is now unit price. It's no longer referencing total sales. So I have to go in here now and change the H to an I to get the total sales back. Of course, that is absolutely something you're going to forget to do. That's something that's going to go wrong. So we need to fix that. We need to do something much more robust because, you know, if a colleague comes along now and says, actually, I don't need that column, or the group decides that's bad practice to insert data columns or delete it, suddenly my query now breaks because I've deleted that column and this column I is no longer within the bounds of my data. I'm only selecting or querying A to H. So I no longer have I within those bounds. I have to go back and change it to H. So all sorts of bad, terrible things going on here. Let's fix it. So let's come into the formula here and delete everything from the comma onwards. So we're just left with select C. And then we're going to change that to col, C-O-L, with a capital C, a lowercase o, lowercase l, 3. And then type col again, 8, and hit enter. And they are just alternative ways to reference the columns within this dataset. And it's the reference, it's the column position within this dataset. So if it started from a different letter, it's relative to this dataset. It's not relative to the very left-hand edge of your spreadsheet. Okay, so col 3 for me, because I was starting from A here, then C was column 3. If my dataset had started from B, then column C would be the second one in this case, but it's the third one here in this example. So col 3, col 8. So that's changing the letters to column numbers. Now what we'll do is we're going to search using xmatch for item, so the column we want within this header row. And there we go. So xmatch, search for item in this header row, and it finds it in position 3. So what we'll do, if we're going to do this xmatch search frequently, rather than always be referring to this header row by the reference like this, the A1 notation, let's go and turn it into a named range. So I highlight the header row, come up to the name box, and I'm going to call it header. Just type that in there. And now, come into my XMatch, I can delete that range reference and instead type header. Hit enter. I'm going to copy this down one more underneath, and we'll search for total sales. And there we go, it finds it in number 8. So you see how handy that is if I'm doing this a lot, I'm looking for a lot of columns, it's much easier to type that in than keep having to grab the header reference. And it just looks much nicer, as you'll see in our final formula as well. Now, if somebody inserts a column, 3 and 9, you see how this query now picks up the wrong one, we haven't fixed that yet, but you see how my XMatch finds the right one, the correct column. So this XMatch is going to be key. So what we do is we come and grab the XMatch, we copy it, and we're going to come back into our query and replace the number 3, which was a hard typed number. We're going to delete it. and close out the string and add in the XMatch formula and then open the string again. And that just, if I highlight this, oops, all of the, there, you see select col 3 and col 8, that's what it's going to evaluate to. It's just building that string for me, but it's dynamic. It searches for header, finds the value 3, and then builds that value col 3. So we'll hit enter, and then we'll copy in the other one. So copy, delete the 8, and just ampersand, which joins strings together. Add this other part of the string here. And now when I highlight the whole thing to check, there we go. Select column 3 and column 8. So that's working fine. It's building that for me. I hit enter. And now if I insert a column, my query still picks up the exact two columns I'm interested in. If two columns were deleted in the future, it still grabs the right two columns for me. And again, you can just check that it's dynamically building this. So it's now looking for columns 3 and 7 because we deleted that column. So if you found this video useful, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to improve your Google Sheets knowledge, consider subscribing just below. Thanks for watching.